Hi, hope you guys are doing well. So today I'll be showing you how to make this crystal material. This crystal material is heavily dependent on geometry because the node setup is very simple, and it also tackles the problem of the emission shader in EV we all have. So there's actually going to be a loophole. So first of all, we take the cube, scale it on the z-axis, tab into the edit mode, go to face select mode, select the top face, extrude EZ and 1. Then vertices, merge vertices at center, do the same but with minus 1 to the bottom side with minus 1 at center, then select all subdivided by once, just once, tap to go back into solid mode, add modifier and subdivision surface modifier just by one level, apply it, and you see now go into the decimate modifier, ratio should be 0.7, triangulate, apply it. See, now we have these triangular faces like crystal. So click random vertices, edges, grab them and move them around because this material is heavily dependent on, again like I said before, on geometry. You can add more geometry if you want. I'm just adding a little bit. Yeah, like you could have subdivided twice or something. Now going to modifiers, displace modifier, strength should be 0.6. go into the texture, next, go with Voronoi, apply it, then again displace modifier, strength of 0.6, new texture, but this time it's going to be noise texture. See, we have this weird looking geometry crystalline. A simple crystal material, crystal geometry won't be good. So now for the material, this is the material. It's really simple. We have a mix shader with 0.9 ratio on the top end. We have a glass BSCF backman. These three colors have to be the same, and the subsurface has to be darker for this material to work. So the roughness is 0, IQR is 0.3. Then we have another mix shader with the first mix shader, but this time the ratio is 0.5. It has a translucent BSCF with the same color as the others, and a principal BSCF GGX Christian Blu-ray, the same color as the others. Subsurface is 0.195 and the color should be slightly more darker than the other. Metallic, everything else is 0, clear coat is 1, clear coat roughness is also 0, IQR is 1.33. These values are important. Transmission and transmission reference is 0, alpha and n. And another important part of this material is that the blend mode is alpha blend, okay, and shadow mode, it's so unsure, I just had it alpha clip, but alpha blend for starters. I'll show you another trick later on. And you also need to have ambient occlusion, bloom and screen space reflections enabled for this material to work really gracefully. So now it's still not finished, let's go into rendered view. You see, it's still not finished. So the finishing touch is that we take the light, grab it, and you guessed it, we're going to put it inside the crystal material. You see, this is a really graceful, beautiful material over here. And you can parent the light to the crystal. The light is selected, then we shift click the crystal and control P to parent it. So that way, whenever you move the crystal, the light is also moving along with it. And now for the other trick I was telling you about. Basically, if you change the blend mode, and this is in EV, okay, it won't work in cycles. That's the good part. If you change the blend mode from alpha blend to alpha clip, if you change it to alpha clip, you basically get another material. So you're basically getting two materials in one by just changing just one setting. So I hope you guys liked it. I will keep making more tutorials. I'll see you next week. If you like this video, if you like the tutorials, like the video, please comment, share with a friend who also wants to learn, subscribe to my channel, it really helps. The response to the last video was really amazing, and I really hope I get the same response in this one. So see you next week. Goodbye.